الحمدللہ نحمده نستعین ونستغفر ونعوذ باللہ من شرور انفسنا ومن سیئات اعمالنا من یهد اللہ فلا مضل له ومن یضلل فلا هادی له واشهد ان لا الہ الا اللہ وحده لا شریک له واشهد ان محمدا عبده ورسوله بعد اعوذ باللہ من الشیطان الرجیم بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم والراسخون في العلم يقولون آمنا به كل من عند ربنا وما يذكر الا اولو الالباب صدق الله العظيم. My respected brothers and sisters, today I'm going to talk to you about a very important subject, and that subject is very important for all of us as a Muslim, and that subject is of yaqeen, certainty, having firm belief, you know, having iman through our tongue, lip service, declaring faith is one thing, but having that firm belief in heart is a totally different station. And once we will have this yaqeen in our heart, our situation, our actions, our behavior, our conduct, the way we approach things will be totally different. So today my job will be, inshallah, that I will walk you through, not only you, to myself as well, so that we can learn few things, so we can develop that firm belief in our hearts, so that we can really benefit from all the fruits of the Quran and the teachings of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This yaqeen is certainty. For that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us, one is our fitra and one is our intellect. Our intellect is to ask questions, and that's why we discover so many discoveries all around us. So the job of intellect is to ask questions, one question after the other, one question after the other. And fitra, the nature, is to guide me towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This intellect can take me to a station, and from there onward, I have to rely on somebody to guide me for the unseen. Because unseen I cannot see, the ghaib I cannot see in this dunya, that is my test. But this is a rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that He has sent down more or less 124,000 messengers on this earth to guide us, to give us information, the information which is, you know, with certainty about the unseen, about the ghaib. My brothers and my sisters, that's why Iqbal in one of the poetry, he says, guzar ja aqal se aage ke ye noor chiraghe raah hai manzil nahi hai. This intellect is not a destiny. It can take you to certain point, but from there onward, then you have to rely on somebody. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made another arrangement for us to develop this yaqeen. Ayat of Quran and ayat of the universe. Like in ayat of Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is teaching us the stories of the nations of past. Allah is sharing with us the information about His kainat, about this His universe. And Allah is telling us through Quran the behavior of the previous nations. Allah is guiding us through those ayat that you should adopt this behavior, and Allah has given so many examples to develop this yaqeen that whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, that is the perfect narration. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made arrangement in this universe. All these signs spread it all around us. The bird flying, the flowers, the trees, the mountains, sky, rain, and look at the sea and sea animals, and go to safari, see all these creatures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all around us. Our own existence, These are all ayahs, signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us, to take us to a station. From there, all the anbiya of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can guide us. And they all came different time, different places. Most of them. Some are coming in Iraq. Some are coming in Balad al-Sham. Some are coming, you know, in different other parts of the world. Makkah. But with the same message, there was no communication between them. There was no internet, there was no text messaging, there was no Facebook. The same message, that there is only one God that you should worship. Same message. And these were the most trustworthy people of their time. Even their enemies were not able to say anything bad about them, that they are the liars or they are the cheaters. No. Abu Sufyan, before he became Muslim, in the castle, the palace of Caesar Rome, he said, Caesar Rome asked him, tell me about this man Muhammad. Abu Sufyan says that I was about to say some, you know, fabricated things about him. But I was afraid that my own people will say that you lied. So even the enemies were saying these were the most trustworthy, honest people of their time. My brothers and my sisters. And they have also said the very same message, that have this firm belief on the unseen. My brothers and my sisters, you know, I will share with you one ayah which really, you know, speaks on this very subject. بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الذين يذكرون الله قياما وقعودا وعلى جنوبهم ويتفكرون في خلق السماوات والأرض ربنا ما خلقت هذا باطلا سبحانك فقنا عذاب النار. You know, the people who of faith, they do zikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in all three conditions, you know, standing, sitting, laying down, and then they do tafakkur, they do tadabbur on the ayahs, spread it all around them. And when they see these ayahs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, immediately comes out of their mind, Rabbana ma khalaqta hadha batila. Ya Rabbul Alameen, you have not created all this for nothing. Subhanaka faqina azabanna. And your creation is perfect. You are flawless. Everything you created, Ya Rabbul Alameen, it's perfect. Nobody can find any flaws in the creation of you. And these are the enough signs for us to believe in you. That's why there was an Arab Badwan. You know, sometime somebody asked him, do you believe in God? He said, yes. How come? He said, as I am in desert, I see the droppings of my camel and I see footprints of my camel. I will immediately understand. I know that my camel is around somewhere here. So don't you see all these signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all around me? Brothers and sisters, we need those eyes that we can see the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And these signs are good enough for you and me to have the firm belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My brothers and my sisters, you know, I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He gives us this wisdom, that we can be like a pupil. The ayah I read in the beginning, وَالرَّاسِخُونَ فِي الْعِلْمِ يَقُولُونَ آمَنَّا بِهِ كُلٌّ مِّنْ عِنْدِ رَبِّنَا وَمَا يَذَّكَّرُ إِلَّا أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has invited us almost 850 times in Quran to have tadabbur, ponder on my ayahs with the eyes, through the eyes of your heart. And then you will immediately will be able to acknowledge that all this is from your Rabbul Alameen. the pupil of intellect, وَالرَّاسِخُونَ فِي الْإِلْمِ, these are the people, they will immediately declare, يَقُولُونَ آمَنَّا بِهِ كُلُّم مِّنْ إِنْدِ رَبِّنَا, this is all from our Lord. And these are the people, وَمَا يَذَّكَّرُ إِلَّا أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ, and nobody other than the intellect people, they ponder on our ayahs, and they immediately realize, this is all from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imam Ibn Taymiyyah, you know, said a very beautiful thing about the ayahs of Quran. He said, Quran has come with ayahs, they are beyond our intellect, not against our intellect. Quran has come with ayahs, they are beyond our intellect. We cannot understand because of the limitation of our brain, but they are not against our intellect. So these ayahs are for us to think of the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, to think about the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that to run a little office or house or a small company, how difficult it is, how much struggle and effort it needs. But look at this whole kainat, about which we don't even know the limits. Our telescope is the limit, and it's the limit to see all around us. The bigger, the powerful telescope we make, more we will be able to see, my brothers and my sisters. So limitations is our knowledge. وَمَا أُوتِيتُم مِّنَ الْعِلْمِ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا, that whatever information we have is very little bit what Allah has given us. So this should also humble us to have this yaqeen on the information that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has provided you and me. So after seeing all these signs around us, this is all to guide us towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wallahi, if we have the yaqeen, if we have certainty in our hearts of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the promises Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made, we will meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala every day. The level of our iman will be at different station. So I'm going to give you, you know, few examples so that we can really understand the true value and what really the yaqeen is. Because this yaqeen will be the main motivational force, inspiration for all of us. You know, there was a man, Johann Treber, a German tightrope rider. You know, on tightrope they ride bicycle. And in 2005, he made a world record. And the stadium full of people. And he rode his bicycle 53 kilometers per hour. Not only himself, but he actually took his infant child and his wife as well to ride with him. And after he finished, he came on the mic and asked everybody, "Do you all witness what I just did? The world record?" And everybody said that you have made a world record, and everybody was clapping and you know, smiling and slogans and, you know, beautiful scene. He asked the same question 3 times and everybody witnessed. Then he surprised everybody and said, "I want one of you to come here and ride with me, so I will take you from one end to the other end of the rope." Not a single person came to ride with him, because they had this, you know, iman, this faith through lip service, but in their heart they were not sure that he will be able to take them on the other end of the rope or not. Same thing is of our iman, my brothers and my sisters. That we do say La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, but we really do not have that yaqeen, that firm belief, my brothers and my sisters. There was a man, mountain climber, And he was trying to climb on a mountain at a very dark night. Very dark night. And as he was going up, all of a sudden he fell down. And he was holding to his rope. But he was not sure that how far he is from the ground. So he prayed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Allah, help me so that I can, you know, save me. So save my life, because you are the only one who can save me. And the voice comes that I am your Lord, I am your Khuda, I am asking you to let this rope go. My brothers and my sisters, then Satan whispered in his ear, oh no, maybe this is not God. Or if you let this rope go, you may fall down and you may hurt yourself, you may die. And all night this is what happened. It was a cold, freezing night. And every time he supplicates, sound voice comes and he replies to the voice, no, this is not, I'm not going to let this rope go. In the morning, people found his dead body, you know, holding to that rope. And he was just 4 feet above the ground. Brothers and sisters, we all are holding some kind of rope in our life. And we do not want to let it go because we rely more on that rope than the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Quran or the promise of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is our condition. Every day we come across situation. My brothers and my sisters, you know, this another example I will share with you, and that example is of Bahlul. You know, I'm going to give you now a few examples which can really inspire us. And these were the Darvish, Majnoon, you know, people that they have taught so many lessons to us that can make sense to us. And we can relate, you know, these stories with our everyday life. Bahlul in the time of Harun Rashid was a Majnoon, was Darvish. And one day after Fajr Salah, Harun Rashid was going on walk with his wife Zubaydah, and he saw Bahlul making some mud houses. So he asked Bahlul, what are you doing? He said, I'm making Jannah houses. So Harun Rashid asked him, how much are you selling it for? He said, 1,000 dinar. Harun Rashid asked him, is anybody buying it? He said, nobody buys it. Nobody is willing to buy these houses of Jannah. Zubaydah, his wife, said to Bahlul, I'm going to buy one house. Bahlul, give me one house and here is 1,000 dinar. They went to their castle, palace, and Harun Rashid saw a dream at night that he is in a castle which is million times more beautiful than his own palace. And he was looking all around and seeing that who has this palace. And he asked the servants in this palace, whose palace is this? They said, this is a palace of Zubaydah. Harun Rashid woke up from his dream and it was difficult for him to wait for Fajr Salah so that he can go and meet Bahlul. He finishes Fajr Salah, rushes to Bahlul and asks Bahlul. And Bahlul was busy making Jannah houses. That what are you doing making Jannah houses? Are you going to sell it? Yes. How much is the price? He said, today price is whatever your kingdom contains, all the treasures of your kingdom. And Harun Rashid said, how come yesterday you were saying 1,000 dinar, today you are saying all the treasures of my kingdom? He said, yes, because 1,000 dinar price was before your dream. After dream, even if you give everything you have, you still will not be able to buy this Jannah houses. My brothers and my sister, that is the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned in Quran, that day people will be willing to give everything which all this earth contains. But this is a one-way traffic. You cannot come back. On that day, there will be no transactions, no buying and selling. It's just one-way traffic. Whatever you do here in Darul, you know, Darul Amal, then Akhira is Darul Jaza. There is no Darul Amal. There is no action there. My brothers and my sisters, that we all are like Harun Rashid, that we do not trust, we do not believe on all the teachings, and we rely more on our intellect, on our knowledge, on our information. And as I said, you know, our intellect can take us to one station. From that station, we have to rely on somebody. Like we rely in our everyday life. You know, the patient relying on doctor, kids are relying on their parents, and we rely on so many people in our life every day. My brothers, this aqal is a noor, this intellect is a noor which can take you and me to one point, and from there on we will rely on these most trustworthy people the planet has ever seen, this earth has ever seen. I'll share with you one more example from Imam Ghazali. You know, Imam Ghazali says there was a group of people and they were going through, you know, passing through a tunnel. The tunnel was very dark, and when they had to pass through this tunnel, they were told this is a one-way traffic, you cannot come back. And there were some righteous people standing on one side of the tunnel, and they say, as you pass through the tunnel, the stones, pebbles come on your way, collect them in your pockets, wherever you can store them. The group of those people say, you know, passing through tunnel, dark, there might be a ditch, we may fall down. This in itself is a hardship. Then, you know, forget about this collecting pebbles or stones. But there was other group of people, they said, you know, these are wise people. If they are advising something, let's listen to them. So they collected whatever was coming on their way. And as soon as they reached to the other end of the tunnel in the light, they saw these were not just pebbles or stones. These were the most precious stones, diamonds and gold. Imagine, Imam Ghazali says, the reaction of the people who have rejected the advice of the wise people. And they were biting their hands, my brothers and my sisters. And the one who have collected some, they were also regretting why they wouldn't collect it more of it. That's what exactly is going to happen on that day of Hasra, that day of regret. The day of Hashr is a day of regret also for the people who have not listened to these prophets. And the people who have done good deed, they will regret why they didn't do more of it, so they can get more reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They would have made more happy to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My brothers and my sisters, I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He gives you and me this tawfiq, that we can take advantage of this life before our eye gets closed in this dunya. Because as soon as my eye will close, وَعْبُدْ رَبَّكَ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ, as soon as this door of this dunya will close, the window of Akhira will open, and I will be able to see all the promises made in Quran and the hadith of Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. I will be able to see immediately right after my eyes close from this dunya, and I go in the noor of the life of hereafter. وَعْبُدْ رَبَّكَ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ. That's why we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He keeps us on the path of Islam until that moment comes when my eye will close, and that moment is definitely going to come in the life of everyone, king or slave or servant, rich, poor, sick, healthy, everybody has to face death one day. So I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He gives you to me tawfiq, that we can take advantage of the time we have. And then when we leave from this dunya, that we have kalma, la ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah on our tongue. So let's have this yaqeen There is promise made by these prophets, 124,000 more or less prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They have also advised, collect these pebbles. You know, your salah is a pebble. Your som, your fasting is pebble. Being nice with people is pebble. Do charity is pebble. These are the stones. Collect them. You may not know the value of this salah today, the fasting today, the charity today. But when your eye will close, وَعْبُدْ رَبَّكَ حَتَّى يَاتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ, the moment of yaqeen will come, you will be able to see these stones are the precious stones. These are gold and diamond. These are the treasures. And these treasures will become your noor. Our hasanat of this dunya, our good deeds of this dunya will become noor of our path, of our life in hereafter. My brothers and my sisters, I will close with this dua that may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us understand this before it's too late. Before it's too late. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.